हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज कविता विक्टर वेलकमिंग यू टू द सेकेंड सेशन ऑफ दिस इंग्लिश क्लास ऑफ बसवा रेसिडेंशियल गर्ल्स स्कूल 10th स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ द पोएम एब्राहम लिंकन्स लेटर टू हिज सन्स टीचर. एज वी सॉ इन द फर्स्ट सेशन, एब्राहम लिंकन वॉज द 16th प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका. He is considered one of the best presidents, not only of the country but of the whole world. Okay, and he is a man of integrity. He was very honest. It is very difficult to find a person like him. And now we find here that he is writing a letter to the teacher of his son who is going to start school. He is not making any big demands. He is only requesting. Okay, he is asking his teacher to teach the son certain values of life. Academically less, and for life it is more. Now we will continue. So it goes like this: try to give my son the strength not to follow the crowd when everyone is getting on the bandwagon. Teach him to listen to all men, but teach him also to filter all he hears on a screen of truth. Okay, so he says, teach my son, teach him so much to have so much strength that he will not follow the crowd blindly, but have his own way of thinking and have belief in his thinking that he doesn't have to follow the crowd. So it is like a slang to say, I also got into the bandwagon. If everybody of your friends have taken up engineering, even though you don't want to take up engineering, you just took it because you want to be with that group of friends, then maybe you will say, I also got into the bandwagon of engineers, because you don't want to be unique, but you just want to follow your friends. Okay, so here he is telling he doesn't want his son to be like that. So he is also requesting him to teach him to listen to all men, but teach him also to filter all he hears on a screen of truth. So whatever he hears, he shouldn't believe it blindly and imagine that they are all truth. So as a filter, what does a filter do? It filters out, it removes all impurities, it holds the impurities and lets all the other pure things to pass through it, right? So the same way the boy needs to have a filter on the screen of truth. So the filter should be the truth. So whatever he hears others telling him, he should just, instead of believing it blindly, he should process it and think, okay, this person has told me this, let me just go through this and verify the facts and find out whether it is true or not. So he has to have so much of discernment or so much wisdom to do that and take only the good that comes through. So whatever comes good comes through that filter, he should take only that. Teach him, if you can, how to laugh when he is sad. So there will be times for everybody where you have to go through a little bit of sadness. So he should learn that sadness is not permanent. Okay, even through that sadness, he should know how to laugh. He should have full control over his emotions. Teach him there is no shame in tears. So many people will say, you're a boy, you should not cry, boys don't cry, or don't show your tears, stop crying, stop being a baby. But sometimes you feel sad. So when you feel sad, you have to cry. You feel like crying, shouldn't always hold back your emotions. So there is no shame, there is no loss of manliness if you cry. Even for a woman, whether it be a man or woman, it is actually brave to show your emotions sometimes. If you feel like crying, there is no shame in crying. The boy should learn that. Teach him to scoff at cynics. So if cynic is someone who thinks only they are great, and they might criticize you saying you are below me, you are low, you are inferior. To such people, he has to ignore them, he has to scold them, and he has to just stop them and beware of too much sweetness. So if someone is scolding you also, you should know how to handle them. And if someone is being too sweet also, you have to be very careful of that person. Teach him to sell his brawn and brain to the highest bidder. Brawn is strength, physical strength. Brain is the intellectual strength. So he should know to use these two to his benefit. If at his work or anywhere, somebody is ready to pay him money in return for his brain or in return for his intelligence or for his strength, he should be ready to give it, he should be ready to sell it. But never put a price tag on his soul. So what does soul signify? Your virtues, your good character. So that on your soul, anybody tells to sell your soul, that means to do something bad in return for money, then he should never do it. So only if you are a person of integrity, if you have conscience, then you will never do this. So his soul is what he has to protect. Teach him to close his ears to a howling mob. Mob is a group, okay? Group of people, they don't think, okay? They are doing something, they are just following the group. If one person is screaming slogans against some politician or some person, everybody joins in and they'll also scream. But it usually, that the most of the people in that mob will not even know what they are doing. That is called a mob mentality. So here he's telling, if some mob, they are howling, means usually what is howling? The sounds made by dogs and wolves, no? That is howling sound. So if that mob is making so much noise, which is nonsense, which is not making any sense, just to close your ears, because you can't avoid it, you can't make them stop. So just close your ears and stand and fight again. If somebody is trying to attack, you have to be brave enough to stand up for your opinions, and you should be strong enough to fight. If he thinks he is right, if somebody is telling you something and that you are wrong, and you very well know that you are right, you should be brave enough to fight against them. Treat him gently. So the father is asking the teacher to teach his son gently. Treat his son gently, but do not cuddle him. So cuddling is like too much petting and pampering of the... Oh, usually who will cuddle? Mothers will cuddle their infants, small babies, not even the old children. So that is what cuddling is. So the father is telling, sir, don't cuddle him too much. Don't pet him too much. Don't pamper him. But don't be rude to him. Be gentle, but not too much. Because why he shouldn't do that is, only the test of fire makes fine steel. If you have seen in any videos or on any discovery or history channels, how is steel made? That it is melted. So if steel has to be melted, if that iron, they'll mix it with so many other things. If steel has to be melted, it has to go through very, very high temperature of heat. Very, very high heat. So only that fire, that intense heat will melt the steel and make it to get a proper shape. So he is using this steel as a comparison, as a metaphor here. He is telling only if it goes through that fire, we will get fine steel. So the same way, this boy also needs to go through certain difficulties so that when he grows up, he will become a strong person of fine character. That is what his father wants him. So too much of cuddling, what will happen? The boy will become, he will keep expecting the same pampering from everybody, which will not happen, isn't it? Let him have the courage to be impatient. Sometimes you have to be impatient. Without impatient means no patience, having no patience. Sometimes, but not always, he can have, let him have impatience, let him have the patience to be brave. Sometimes you have to be brave, isn't it? So, for that bravery, sometimes you have to be patient. So, he should know when to have patience, when to have impatience. Teach him always to have sublime faith in himself. Sublime means supreme, immense faith. In whom? In himself. First, he has to believe in himself, because then he will have sublime faith in mankind. Only when he has faith in himself, he will believe mankind. Mankind means others, other people. Or if he doesn't believe himself, if he doesn't have faith in himself, then how will he believe others? Then how will he be able to survive in this society? This is a big order. So the father is telling, whatever I am asking you to do, it is a big order. Means I am asking too much from you. That means the father knows all these values to be taught to the boy, it is not an easy task. That is why he is telling, I know very well that it is too much, it is difficult, but still see what you can do. We tell, right, in Kannada they'll say nimge eshtagutto nodi, eshtagutto maadi. That is what they say in Kannada, jitni bhi ho sake in Hindi. So the same way he is telling, but see what you can do. So how much ever you are able to do, do it. He is such a fine little fellow. In the end, he is praising his son. He is telling he is a good boy. He is a fine little boy. That means it will not be difficult for you to teach him all this. My son. He is telling he is a fine little boy. My son. My son is a fine little boy. You might not find it difficult to teach him, sir. But I know I am asking you too much. So how much ever is possible, please teach him. This is what Abraham Lincoln is telling this teacher. So we have come to the end of this session. I hope you all liked this poem. You also might, as I told you in the previous class also, you might remember what your parents come and tell your teachers. What you can do is, as a small assignment, I will be sending you a quiz. So along with that quiz, you can write in a small sheet of paper, maybe 5 to 6 sentences, any memorable conversations your parents had with your teacher regarding you, like what your parents asked or requested or demanded of your teacher about you. Okay, let me see whose conversations are very interesting. Okay, I'll be waiting for your response. Okay, all the best, students. I hope you enjoyed this poem. Please go through it again. You read the textbook, read the poem once again. There are so many new words, and the quiz is also based on the poem. So read the poem again. Okay. See you all. Bye-bye. Have a nice day.